There's this interaction that happens when I'm in a completely focused state, pushing on that edge, and I'm in this place that I find immensely compelling. It's just a certain something that you feel here. It's kind of hard to describe. The place really inhabits the mind. I chose to do Nolan's 14 solo and unsupported to have a more personal, more intimate experience with the place. Being alone in the mountains is an opportunity and really a privilege to be able to dig a little deeper into my mind and get into a headspace where I can really be confronted to myself. The context allows you to elevate and to have a richer and deeper experience. By putting myself in elective and arbitrary situations that feel challenging and difficult, I know that out of that is going to come a certain amount of growth. The next day, as the sun rises, I start to feel refreshed. Like I kind of weathered the storm there, and everything's working out now, and I start to get more confident in my style and what I'm doing here with just this little tiny pack, and I feel like I'm living up to the aesthetic ideal that I'd set out to try and you know, live up to. And then as soon as I get caught up into that thinking, things start to unravel. As the end becomes more tangible, my ego starts to take over. And all I can really think about in that moment is time. I forget about the process. I stop thinking about this aesthetic ideal, and I'm just sucked into this need for validation and this pursuit of this record, and my mind just becomes absorbed with all of this competitive angst. Am I here for just the time, or do I really have a pure intent? In daily life, I can pretend, right? I can just pretend. I can sort of put on a facade of coolness and knowingness, and you could sort of choose a little bit more how you want to present yourself to the world. 36 hours into Nolan's, I'm not choosing how I'm presenting myself to the world. I'm just there, and I'm just who I am. A conflicted person, an imperfect person, trying to learn something about himself. And maybe that's the whole point of this thing, is to get into that headspace and really tap into that self-reflection. I guess I hope I've gained some perspective. Hold on.
38. Okay, tiring.